In that today's session, we'll discuss about the power supply units and the components required to assemble a computer. First, we'll start with the power supply units, that is SMPS. SMPS stands for switched mode power supply. SMPS stands for switched mode power supply. The next question comes concerned to this is for 1 mark, that is, what is the use of SMPS? The answer for that is, you can answer in two ways. The first way is, an SMPS converts 230 volts of AC power to 5 to 12 volts of DC power. This is one. Or an SMPS converts AC power to DC power. It means value chhod bhi sakte, without value also you can write. For that also you'll get a marks. Then what it contains, the major components of SMPS are power cord plug, a fan for cooling because the SMPS generates a lot of heat. So after knowing this, you can see now the fan. This is the fan, right? This is part of SMPS. If you see the complete SMPS, it looks like this. We are showing you here a back view of SMPS. Normally, when you observe the back of a computer CPU, that is a cabinet or a case, you can observe this view at the back side. And this button depends on the models. It may contain a button or without the buttons, power buttons, on off buttons. But from main line, we are connecting directly to this SMPS. This SMPS collects 230 volts of AC from our main line and it converts to 5 to 12 volts of DC, which are required for our components of the computers with the help of these cables. The SMPS are commonly available in 450 watts to 550 watts SMPS. These are common. Then, after knowing SMPS. Now you can see the second component is UPS. UPS stands for uninterruptible power supply. For 1 mark, you may get this. Expand UPS. You have to write the answer as uninterruptible power supply. Then, based on this, you may get one more 1 mark question, that is, what is the use of UPS? And UPS keeps a computer running for several minutes to few hours after a power failure. अगर current गई है तो computer off नहीं हो रहा, आपका चल रहा है, थोड़े minute के लिए भी चल सकते हैं, नहीं तो थोड़े घंटे के लिए भी चल सकते हैं, तो आप लोग UPS connected हैं. An UPS is a power supply that includes a battery to maintain power in the event of power failure. What it contains? The UPS contains a battery. Depends on the battery capacity, you will get a continuous power supply even though the power is off. After power failure, in the event of power failure, we'll get the power supply continuously from the UPS battery. That may be off for few minutes or few hours. Then there are two types of UPS are available. Number one is called as offline UPS, and number two is called as online UPS. Now you can observe here, right? First one you should ask offline UPS, and the second diagram we are showing it as online UPS. Now we'll study about these two, online UPS and offline UPS. First, offline UPS. These offline UPS are also called as standby UPS. Standby UPS. Offline UPS monitors the power line and switches to battery power as soon as it detects a problem. So in this case, what happens? When we are using offline UPS means when there is a power supply, it directly, the UPS directly supplies that power to the devices. If there is some problem in the main power line, then it switches to its battery, and from battery it supplies power to the devices. Agar current chalu hai to seedha wo main line hi supply karte rehta hai. Agar wo main line mein, main power line mein kuch problems hai to, right? If there are some problems in the main line, maybe fluctuation problems or power failed, at that time kya hota hai, this offline UPS supplies the power to the devices through its battery. Battery se power supply karta, because already it is charged. Then if you compare one more point, that is offline versus online, the offline UPS are cheaper than online UPS, even though the backup capacities are same. Normally for home purpose, to maintain our systems, we'll use offline UPS. Its backup capacity may be around 15 to 20 minutes backup. Then second one, online UPS. An online UPS continuously provides power from its own inverter even when the power line is functioning properly. It means even the main power line is working properly, then also these online UPS will supply the power to the devices through its battery only. It means in this case there is no switchover circuits, whereas in case of offline UPS, the circuit is switch over from main line to inverter circuit. But when in case of online UPS, the online UPS will directly supply power from its own inverter even though the main power line is working properly. It means you cannot feel the power problems if you are using online UPS. There is no fluctuations also. Whereas in case of offline, for a fraction of a second, you can feel that the power is having some problem. Main line is having some problem. That's why our UPS is switching over to the inverters. But in case of online, you cannot feel that. So these online UPS are more costlier than offline UPS. Okay. UPS के बारे में. Then the last heading of that chapter 1, typical configuration of computer, last heading is, after knowing the components of computer. Now we are capable of making a list of components required for assembling a system. तो कंप्यूटर असेंबल करने के लिए कौन सा कंपोनेंट चाहिए सभी हमको जानकारी मिल गई है अब पूरा लेसन सीखने के बाद. That's why first we are making a list of them, which are all the components required to assemble a system. First we need a processor, that is CPU or microprocessor. The popular one is Intel. Its speed is in gigahertz. Then motherboard is required. We have studied different types of motherboards. In that, the best one you have to choose nowadays is ATX motherboards with a recent chipset technology. Recent technology chipsets are used in this motherboard. Then you can choose the primary memory required for your work. How much memory is needed? Whether I have to go with 1 GB or 2 GB, like that, you can select the capacity of primary memory. Then you can select hard disk and its capacity, which company hard disk you want, then what may be the capacity of your hard disk. Nowadays commonly you will get around 1 TB hard disk are available. Then you can choose cabinet, right, with that SMPs. Cabinet with SMPs you'll get. Choose that cabinet and SMPs. Cabinet models and SMPs wattages, you can select it. As I said in the previous slide, that it may be of 450 watts to 550 watts SMPs we need. You can choose them. Then we go for keyboard. We all know that there are different types of keyboards are available. From that, which one is suitable for your job? You can choose that. Either wired or wireless keyboards, you can choose it. Then you can go for another input device. Nowadays, commonly we are using that also, that is mouse. Again, in that there are different types of mouse are available. You can choose a scroll mouse or a wireless mouse. Then one output device is compulsorily we need, standard output device, that is a monitor. You can select the monitor. Again, there are different types of color monitors are available. In that you can choose one, either you can go for LCD or LED monitors. Then another output device I mentioned here, that is printer, but it is optional. If you want, you can, otherwise you can leave it. While choosing a printer, if you are purchasing a printer, again we know that there are different types of printers like impact printer and non-impact printers. Depends on your work, either you can choose impact printer, like the commonly used impact printer is dot matrix printer, or if you are going with non-impact printer, a high quality printer, better to go with laser printer. Then nowadays, especially in these days, people are communicating through their devices, either the Androids or the computers. That's why we need nowadays commonly, that is camera. In the past, this was not required because communication was not so much high technology one. Right, technologically it was poor in the decades back, but nowadays the cameras are commonly used in laptops, right? Even Androids uses cameras. Number of cameras or webcam you can say, right? So these are optional, you can use them also. Then mic, if you are going with cameras, then better to go with mic also, right? There are different wattage mics, different model mic, you can choose the required one. Then comes UPS. If it is a single system, better to go with offline UPS of backup of at least 20 minutes. Then speakers, nowadays these are required as one more output device, right? Again, there are different various speakers, different model speakers are available. You can choose any speaker which is required for your work. These are all the components required for assembling a computer. Other than this, we have many things, but these are the standard components required to assemble the computers. First, you have to collect the motherboard, right? Then, how do you learn that? See here, the motherboard, on that, go on connecting or inserting the components required for you, right? All the components are mentioned here. Either it may be an IDA connector is required for us to connect the IDA devices. Then CMOS battery is there, BIOS is there. Then here ATX power connectors are there. You can collect that. Then memory slot is there, DIMM memory slot. Then processor socket is there. You can insert that processor here. Then power connectors. These are the power connectors. Then we discussed the north bridge. This is the north bridge. Then here is the south bridge. This is the south bridge. Then this is the PCIe slot. Then CMOS or BIOS, you'll get CMOS. Then you'll get PCIe slots. Then FDD connector. USB connector, right? Then SATA, front panel connectors. So these are all the different sockets and connectors are available. You can insert the components in the respective slots or sockets. After connecting that components, you can fix this motherboard into the cabinet which you have purchased with an SMPS. Here, if you are observing here, show that. See here, this is the view of SMPS. This is the SMPS. Then we have a motherboard which contains number of components. Some circuitries are there, buses are there, right? Can easily observe here. Here one more you are observing here, an exhaust fan. It means here is our microprocessor. Below this, a microprocessor is available. Then in this part, if you observe a small extended part, that is normally a wire is connected over here. This is a drive, either a CD drive or DVD drive. And this portion contains, right, in this portion, normally we have hard disk, right? Here we will connect the hard disks. If there is a floppy disk, again that is connected over here. Floppy disks, hard disk, floppy disks, but it is nowadays outdated. A drive is there, CD DVD drive, then floppy disk is there. In this part, we are connecting the hard disks. Once all the connections are over, from SMPS, we are connecting the power lines to the needed components. Once this cabinet is closed, your system is ready, assembled. It means it may look like this, right? This is about the chapter number one. We are concluding. So if you like this, share with others and don't forget to subscribe it so that you get continuous updates on different topics. Thank you.